Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Sayın Başbakan, aziz kardeşim
Prime Minister, İmran Han, my dear brother Imran Khan,
iş dünyamızın değerli
distinguished representatives of our business world, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to salute you with my deepest regards.
Esselamu aleyküm ve rahmetullahi ve berekatuhu.
I am happy and honored to be in Pakistan, which we regard as our second home. Right at the outset, I would like to thank the Pakistan authorities and to the people of Pakistan for their for being such a great host. We are experiencing in full our program in Pakistan. Yesterday, we had a sincere conversation with the Honorable President, Mr. Arif Alvi. And today, I had the opportunity to address the parliamentarians, members of the Pakistan National Assembly and the Senate. And right after this business forum, together with my brother Imran Han, we are going to hold the sixth meeting of the High-Level Strategic Cooperation Council. So we will have extended our relations to a higher level. I wish that these meetings, this business forum and our meeting and its Pakistani counterpart for bringing together such a select audience for representing the business communities. The connections that you have established and you will establish, hopefully, will open the door for new businesses, new partnerships. Our relations, we want to increase the level of commercial and economic relations to the level of our political relations. Despite the increase in trade and investment, unfortunately, we see that we are lagging behind the potential. Turkey and Pakistan, who has a total population of over 300 million, has only $800 million of foreign trade, and this is something we cannot accept. So we should quickly increase our bilateral trade to first $1 billion and then bring it up to $5 billion. Of course, we cannot attain these objectives just by goodwill. We have to take determined, clear, and strong steps towards our common objectives. We are aware that the two countries have similar export items. However, there are many complementary industries that would complement each other. Therefore, we need to focus on these areas and we have to bring the trade relations to the level it deserves. And we should not allow protectionism establish walls between us. My dear friends, we have increased investments in the recent times. Turkey's investment in Pakistan is now at $100 million. I'm very happy to see that Turkish companies, from energy to food, from construction to other fields, being active in Turkey. Our companies are working in such a manner that would fit into the friendship of Turkey and Pakistan. They are serving Pakistan. And our companies are actually intending to increase their investments. Anadolu Group has a plan for investment of $200 million. And likewise, Hayat Kim plan of $300 million. Likewise, Sütaş
wants,
will inaugurate a new dairy processing industry in Punjab. These are good news. And in our country, we have 158 companies with Pakistan capital. And their total investments in Turkey is about $100 million. And we wish to see that this number of companies and the amount of investment shall increase. In our, I always underline something on every occasion. We prefer to say international investments rather than foreign investments, because according to our understanding, capital does not have a nationality. Therefore, capital nationalism is not a correct attitude. So we do not see any difference between Turkish companies and international companies investing in Turkey. We are not only supporting international investments with legal regulations, but also we support them institutionally. We have a model of offering Turkish citizenship to certain international investors under certain conditions. So far, no one who believed in Turkey and who invested in Turkey was upset. Did not regret. I believe and I invite Pakistani brothers to have trust in the Turkish economy and to have confidence in into Turkey's future. Turkey has a strong state tradition, young and educated workforce with highly entrepreneurial private industry. It's one of the 20th, it's one of the top 20 economies in the world. We had the public debts of 72%, and we brought it down to 30%. The budget deficit ratio to the national income was 11%, and we brought it down to 2%. Between 2009 and 2018, we provided new employment opportunities to 900,000 people in tourism. We increased the number of tourists from 13 million to 51 million, and we increased our touristic revenues from $8.5 billion to $35 billion. In the last 17 years, we had $22 billion worth of foreign investment, international investment. Our banking industry is strong. Today, Turkish Airlines flies to 126 countries and 328 international destinations. So this is one of the biggest airlines operators in the world. In 2002, we had exports of $26 billion level, and according to just last week's figures, we took it up to $181 billion. Our exports in January increased by 6% compared to the same period of last year. Despite all the attacks, all the economic espionage, regional instabilities, we are continuing successfully on our way. Distinguished business people, we see that Pakistan is taking important steps in facilitating business environment under the leadership of my brother Imran. We are ready to help Pakistan in this respect. We are aware that Pakistan offers a lot of opportunities. As Turkey, we have companies of international renown in the fields of defense, transportation, housing, healthcare, and construction. Our cooperation with Pakistan in the field of defense industry is becoming deeper. In contracting, Turkish companies assumed $3.5 billion worth of 68 projects. And among them, there are important infrastructure and energy projects, especially in energy. Hydroelectric energy, we have contractors who can be of help in this respect. In individual projects and with the effect of China-Pakistan economic corridor projects, we see that the energy problems are now over. We are happy to see that. Our contracting companies, which rank second in the world, would like to enter into light-scale energy and infrastructure projects. Of course, we see that Turkey is not given the same possibilities that are offered to some other countries. China-Pakistan economic corridor projects should be explained to Turkish entrepreneurs much better. We are ready to work on that. In this framework, we can identify a pilot industry, pilot sector investments. We can identify it together and we can bring together a few large-scale companies. Connectivity is very important for our country, and we know that it's important for Pakistan as well. In this respect, Turkmenistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, TAPI, natural gas pipeline, and Turkmenistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan, electrical energy transmission line project will be useful projects in connectivity. TAP on the Turkmenistan leg of TAP Energy project, we have our Çalık holding company. So I believe that it will be beneficial for Pakistan to benefit from the experience of our countries. And Turkish cereals that are followed by millions of people abroad are being followed by Pakistani people as well. So, therefore, we can cooperate in the industry of movie making and serial making. Dear friends, before concluding, I would like to touch upon something which I find important. I learned that Pakistan people prefer Western countries for medical treatment. I think we have to change this attitude now. Turkey is one of the countries, one of the main destinations in the world of medical healthcare and related tourism. We have city hospitals with the latest technology. They have identified, they have set the standards in the industry with the quality of service and with affordable prices. Turkey is far advanced than Western countries. But of course, we have to cooperate. We have established 10 city hospitals with a total bed capacity of 13,000. And we had more than 500,000 foreigners who came to Turkey for medical care, health care. So Turkey should provide you with the same opportunities. And inshallah, I believe that we can make this happen. And hopefully tomorrow we are going to sign today the strategic economic framework together with my brother Imran. With our support, with the efforts of the business people, Turkish, Pakistan, commercial and economic relations will be upgraded to the level it deserves. So we have the will and the intention to be on the side of our private sector companies and to motivate them. I wish you all the best. May God help us. I would like to thank you for your participation. Pakistan, Turkey, dosti zindabad.